Hey guys, this is Katie with the channel Weather Shaman. Welcome if you're new, and a big hello to my returning subscribers. Right now I am outside on the screened-in porch enjoying this beautiful summer day. You can see the trees behind me, the weather above. It is just absolutely beautiful and serene. Today I have a Reiki ASMR shamanic healing session planned for you that is going to focus on the heart chakra and solar plexus chakra energy centers. So two main energy centers. We're going to focus on connecting our solar plexus with our heart so that we can increase our courage, self-confidence, ability to set goals and follow through with them, and to do all this from a place of heart so that we can be more receptive to love and receptive to blessings and receptive to abundance that may be trying to come in. So this will really help connect and heal as we move forward. We have a new moon in Cancer coming up on July 2nd, 2019. So this will really help us navigate these new beginnings and this new fresh start that is trying to come into our lives. Now, first to start, I thought it would be a great idea to start with this tuning fork, which is tuned to the love frequency of 528 Hertz to really open up our heart chakra space and really help us to be more receptive to the healing energy that's trying to come through from the divine. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy. Okay, so now that we have the love frequency and the positive, loving, healing vibes in the air, I want to share with you this little book that I have that's related to the tuning fork, and it's called Tuning the Human Biofield. And basically this book really helps us explore the healing potential that we all have within. Energy healing, holistic lifestyle, all these beautiful healing techniques that heal our DNA, our cells, and help us remember who we are at a soul level. There's a lot of good stuff in here. And since I said we were going to focus on the solar plexus and heart chakra regions, I want to share with you in this book, there is some information on the solar plexus chakra that I bookmarked that I'm going to read to you. The solar plexus chakra resonates with the color yellow, okay? And it corresponds to a Mi frequency, or the E harmonic, and it governs the spleen, pancreas, stomach, kidneys, adrenals, liver, gallbladder, and also corresponds to relationship with mother and father. And it relates to self-confidence, self-esteem, how we interface with others' energies, setting goals, and achieving them. This is all the solar plexus chakra region, which is right in our stomach, the powerhouse of our bodies. Okay, now if our solar plexus chakra is out of balance or out of tune, we may experience bursts of powerlessness or anger. So the way that we can balance that and have a healthy solar plexus chakra is by transmuting that anger or powerlessness into an assertive, courageous, bold stance, the ability to advocate for self, and the ability to complete projects, the ability to go forth with confidence and perfect harmony and alignment. Okay? And for the heart chakra, which is the second chakra we're going to be focusing on, Actually, the heart chakra, there's a little diagram right here. It's right in our heart area in our chest. The heart chakra corresponds to the color green. So all the nature you see behind me, all the trees and the plants, things of that nature, are all vibing on the love frequency, okay? Now also pink can correspond to the higher heart chakra region, which is thought to be just above the heart chakra. So I like to use greens and pinks when I'm doing heart chakra healing. So I have a bunch of pink and green crystals for that area today. I have this green emerald right here. And I have pink calcite and a whole bunch of others. Now, heart chakra corresponds to the F harmonic, or Fa, and it governs the heart and the lungs, and it relates to giving and receiving love, compassion, and gratitude. These are all high vibrational energies, gratitude, love, and compassion, and we need to try to have an equal balance of give and take, or what we are putting out there and what we are receiving or receptive to. If there is an imbalance in the heart chakra region, you could be experiencing sadness, grief, loss, and saying yes to people when you really want to say no, and then you feel kind of like bad inside for saying yes when really you feel like you need to take time to yourself to work on some self-love. So the way that we can transmute this, any of these feelings of grief, loss, or sadness, we can transmute those negative feelings into positive, healthy heart chakra balances. And a healthy heart chakra balance will have basically the ability to follow your heart's desires, the ability to love freely without expectations, love unconditionally, and be more receptive to love from others. You know, a lot of people can fall into the role of caretaking or taking care of others too much, but not taking care of self. That's why self-love is so important. We must be able to love ourselves in order to love others, and then find a healthy balance between that self-love and love of others. So I just wanted to share that with you. And now we're going to go ahead and get started with healing the solar plexus chakra region. Okay, so I have a bunch of yellow and orange stones so that we can really amp up the energies of this session and really make sure we get maximum healing in the solar plexus region. But first, what I'm going to do is I'm going to light a candle. It's in a Himalayan salt rock lamp so that we can focus on the element of fire to ignite the fire and the spark within and give us more courage. Now, as I light the flame, I want you to focus into it and think about what it is you wish to manifest or create in your reality moving forth. What new things do you wish to bring into your life? Focus on that. Fire is a really powerful element that helps give us energy, it gives us power, gives us courage, and reminds us that we hold more power than we realize. Our thoughts create realities, okay? So be really careful with what you're thinking, because the law of attraction is very real. We must really be careful of our thoughts. If you start noticing that you're thinking of something that's not positive, try to turn it into a positive if you can. If you're feeling fearful or nervous, try to say, I am safe. I am protected by the divine. All is well. Okay? So think of what it is you wish to manifest and let that divine spark within you really glow and shine. Okay. So the first solar plexus healing chakra stone that I have is this beautiful piece of pyrite. Okay? This is a very special piece of pyrite. It's a very big chunk, and I believe it came from New Hampshire. And pyrite is really great for increasing our level of courage, increasing our self-esteem, and really, really giving us that ability to tap into our inner power, our inner knowing. so that we can really move forth boldly with confidence and reassurance that the divine has our back in all that we do. Okay, so focus on your stomach, solar plexus chakra region, as I send forth Reiki healing energy from me to you through this pyrite crystal to heal your solar plexus chakra. Just sit back, close your eyes, and relax. Dicomio, dicomio, dicomio. Chokure, chokure, chokure. Seheki, seheki, seheki. Han she ze shonen, han she ze shonen, han she ze shonen. Okay, you may feel a little gurgling in your stomach, or you may be getting a little hot, and that's okay, that's perfectly normal. Just be sure to drink plenty of water after watching this video to rehydrate yourself. That will really help assist with this healing process. Okay. Now the next solar plexus healing stone that I have is this beautiful piece of Libyan gold tektite. It is thought to be from out of this world, from off planet Earth. Tektite is another name for a meteorite. So this is thought to have collided and crashed in Egypt during the ancient times. They used these little glass stones that they found on the ground to increase their power, their ability to manifest, to increase their strength, courage, and boldness. And so right now, I'm sending the frequencies of this crystal from me to you to really, really amp up your courage, your self-esteem, and just to really ignite that spark from within. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to send Reiki energy through this crystal tektite as well, since this is a very powerful healing tool that can assist us with really transmuting any negativity that may be remaining in our solar plexus chakra and really balance and harmonize the energies located there. So you can just sit back and close your eyes once again. Dicomio, dicomio, dicomio. Chokure, chokure, chokure. Seheki, seheki, seheki. Han she ze shonen, han she ze shonen, han she ze shonen. Okay. Hopefully you feel a little bit lighter. The last solar plexus healing stone that I have that I want to share with you is this beautiful piece of citrine. It is a heat-treated citrine point from Brazil, and this holds a lot of power because it really helps increase our level of joy, happiness, and brings forth higher vibrational energies while healing our solar plexus region. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to take this citrine point and I am going to clear your energy centers from your crown down to your root so that we can make sure that all of our energy centers are balanced going forth from the solar plexus to the heart chakra. So I'm going to go around the camera at the top and then work my way down each energy center before we proceed to the heart. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy. And the next thing that I'm also going to do before proceeding to the heart chakra is I'm going to light this piece of Palo Santo to really, really bless the space on a further level, on a higher vibrational frequency, and bring in some more nature-esque, nature-y vibes, since Palo Santo is a beautiful sacred wood that Native Americans use to bless the space and to help us connect back with Mother Earth, nature, and really open that heart space. Okay, so I'm going to light the tip and send Reiki energy through the camera across time and space, so that if you wish to revisit this video at any time, it will still hold the same amount of healing potential. If you're clairsentient, you may be able to smell the sweet notes from this Palo Santo wood. It's got a very sweet, sweet smell. This also helps us connect with our ancestors. It's wonderfully powerful. So what I'm going to do is draw Reiki symbols through the camera across time and space to send Reiki energy from me to you and help you connect with your ancestral roots and help heal you at the cellular level. Daikomyo, 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 Chokure, 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 Seheki, 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 Han She Se Shonen, Han She Se Shonen, Han She Se Shonen. Okay. So hopefully your energy field is feeling lighter, filled with more love, and you feel relaxed and at ease and more sure of yourself. Okay. So for the heart chakra, I have some beautiful crystals that I selected for this. I have this beautiful piece of green apophyllite, and green apophyllite, this is from India. It's a very high vibrational stone that helps us connect with our heart space. Interesting story. This was a piece of green apophyllite. It was a big chunk that I received, and I accidentally dropped it, and it broke into two pieces, and it just so happened to break into the shape of a heart from like this big chunk that was an amorphous shape that didn't have any, you know, particular shape. It just broke into this beautiful heart. And I took that as a sign that this would be perfect, perfect for heart chakra healing. I sleep with it under my pillow at night to help enhance my dreams and help me to stay heart-centered, to remind myself to stay heart-centered. So this helps us connect with the green Anahata chakra, or Anahata chakra. And it helps remind us to connect back with nature as much as we can, get some plants for inside our homes, and to really, really connect our minds with our hearts and have heart-centered awareness in all that we do. For the heart emits a very powerful electromagnetic field around us. Our hearts are one of the most powerful organs in our bodies in terms of the electromagnetic frequencies or fields that it pulses outward to others. We all have the ability to heal ourselves and heal others by just getting in touch with our heart and feeling the energy and doing a heart-centered directed focus to others. Some people, when they pray with good intent and from a place of optimism, by thinking positively and from the heart and picturing what a person would look like happy, healed, and doing well, that person can heal the other person through prayer by sending and transmitting pure love from their heart space to the person they're envisioning, and by envisioning them well, by envisioning them doing well. So if you're ever praying for someone, try to picture them doing well versus not doing well, because what we focus on grows. So if we picture the person that we want to get healthy being healthy already, it will help manifest more quickly and it will help speed up their healing process with the assistance of the divine, of course. So I'm going to send Reiki through this green apophyllite from me to you to heal and balance your heart chakra and help you to become more receptive to love and more generous with love. Dichomio, dichomio, dichomio. Chokure, chokure, chokure. Seheki, seheki, seheki. Han she se shonen. Han she se shonen. Han she se shonen. Okay, so I just sent you some emotional healing, physical healing, spiritual healing, and mental healing across time and space, so that whenever you decide to watch this video, past, present, or future, it will still have the same healing potential and power as it does at the time of this recording. For energy is fluid and works across time and space. It is multidimensional and quantum. Time is merely an illusion. Okay, so anything is possible and dreams do come true. For the higher heart chakra, I've got a pink stone. Now what I have is a very powerful, very sacred crystal. This is a beautiful piece of lavender rose quartz. Now rose quartz is already a very nurturing, loving, healing stone for our higher heart chakra region. But what makes this special is the fact that it's a lavender rose quartz. And so not only does it help us heal our higher heart chakra, but it helps us heal our third eye and our crown chakra, so that we're more open and receptive to divine love too, so that we can be more loving and receptive to help and assistance from angels, our spirit guides, God, Jesus, whatever you believe in. It helps us connect more with the divine from a place of heart. And that increases our level of security, protection, our ability to manifest and create, and to feel inspired, and to heal on all levels. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send the frequencies of this lavender rose quartz across time and space using some more Reiki. Dichomio, dichomio, dichomio. Chokure, chokure, chokure. Seheki, seheki, seheki. Han she se shonen, han she se shonen, han she se shonen. Okay. Now another crystal that's wonderful for opening our heart chakra and connecting us with the divine and clearing our space or blessing our space and increasing our vibrational frequency is this beautiful piece of selenite. Selenite is a very high vibrational crystal, and it's thought to help us connect with the angelic realm, the higher realms, and it helps really raise our vibrational frequency. The selenite wand is very powerful because it helps me to direct and focus energy, especially Reiki healing energy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the selenite wand to clear and recharge and open your energy centers from your crown all the way to your root. I'm going to start by going around the camera like I did with that citrine point earlier to really make sure we're perfectly in alignment and balanced. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy. hopefully you feel lighter and you feel more refreshed, rejuvenated, and feel more open to receiving love, to giving love, and feeling more balanced and harmonized. Okay. The next thing that I have as part of my shaman tools is this beautiful little plant inside of this beautiful glass bowl. And I thought this would help us to reconnect with Mother Earth, or Gaia. For those of you who may have busy, hectic schedules and don't have as much time to connect with nature, I thought this would help by bringing nature from me to you across the camera. Plants really can be healing. They help bring more oxygen into our homes, they increase our vibrational frequency, and they really, really help bring more love into our homes. So if you don't have any indoor plants, I recommend getting some living, real plants, for they hold a lot of healing potential and healing energy. And getting Himalayan salt rock candles or Himalayan salt rock lamps can really help with healing too, because Himalayan salt rock lamps emit negative ions into the air, which purify the air and help protect us from electromagnetic disturbances and electromagnetic frequencies from wireless technologies that aren't so healthy for us. The negative ions from these counteract those harmful EMFs, and they really help protect the human biofields. So really invest in some Himalayan salt rock lamps, or consider if you haven't already. They really, really help a lot. If you're looking to purify your home or looking for more protection from Wi-Fi and all that, maybe consider getting one. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is send some Reiki through this plant from me to you to just fill you up with beautiful, loving vibes from Mother Earth to nurture you and to reconnect you with the pulse of the earth and the love that she has for all of us, for all of creation. Daikomyo, 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 Chokure, 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 Seheki, 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 Han She Ze Shonen, Han She Ze Shonen, Han She Ze Shonen. Okay, so that's all I have for you today. If you like this video and you would like more like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe below. Click that subscribe button. And please leave any comments that you may have. I would love to hear from you and hear your feedback. I hope you have a lovely, blessed rest of the day. Sending you an abundance of peace, love, and light from me to you. Namaste.